Today I want to talk to you about Huawei, a company that's been dominating our third page news cycle, beating out EPA deregulation, Tesla's complete market failure, and the two or three wars we might currently be involved in. Let me tell you, their company has had a lot to talk about at this year's Christmas party, between their alleged spying in Poland, but I've seen a Cold War movie, I think spying is the Polish national pastime. Their CFO still being a Canadian prisoner, although it's rich people imprisonment, so when she leaves the mansion to go shopping in Vancouver, the government just gives her a designer ankle bracelet. And hey, it even lights up and makes fun noises if you stay up past 11. The FBI, CIA, and NSA all recently came together to give it a one-star review and encourage American consumers not to use Huawei phones. And Western governments, as well as Japan, have all been dropping them from contracts left and right. So it might sound like this company's circling the drain, but with all this...
Huawei Technologies overtook Apple to become the world's number two smartphone maker in the second quarter this year, according to research firm International Data Corporation.
Ooh, International Data Corporation. That doesn't sound like a company that had 10 seconds to come up with its name. Although, I chose to call myself, that's all I have to say about that, so I shouldn't be throwing any stones. Anyways, yes, this company has surpassed the iPhone in smartphone sales, which is pretty crazy considering this is the iPhone we're talking about. I've seen groups that would put the Stoika bread lines to shame just to see Tim Cook fail to unlock one with his face. Today I want to talk about what this company is and why it seems to be of such concern to Western governments. So first, what is Huawei and why am I talking about them today? Well, Huawei is currently the world's largest telecommunications equipment manufacturer. As we mentioned, they make phones and computers, but they're working on a new project that seems to be giving a lot of people some pause.
This is a global race to 5G. We won the race in 4G, and that's why all the innovation happens here in the United States. We've got 30 trials here in the United States, but China's got 100 trials going on this year.
Now, I realize I'm not a tech blogger, so I'm not going to go crazy with the G talk. As long as my internet bill doesn't go up a G, I'm happy. Just know that 5G is supposed to be ridiculously faster than 4G, which means you'll get access to the webcomic a nanosecond faster. It does also have larger implications for self-driving cars and other technology that people would prefer to have fast reflexes. So, alright, we're in a race to get to 5G technology. Only problem, that report came out a year ago, and it's reported that as of November 29th, 2018, Huawei is the only company to have successfully created 5G internet, and they already have 22 contracts to install 5G internet around the world. Hey, free market, I hear you saying, but this is where the controversy comes in.
This week, New Zealand blocked its top telecom company, Spark, from using Huawei's equipment to build its 5G mobile network.
The Australian government has banned the telecommunication giant from working on its 5G communications network.
Japan plans to ban government purchases of equipment from the tech companies Huawei and ZTE.
A few companies are still on the fence about incorporating 5G technology from a Chinese company, including Great Britain, Canada, Germany, Italy, and India. So why not get your internet from China, a country where, if there's one thing they're known for, it's internet accessibility. Really though, Huawei is a private Chinese company that has designed an impressively good product at a great price. Why not upgrade your country's internet speeds? Well, that's a debate that's currently going on in quite a few countries from Europe to Africa. On one hand, our current FBI director and sim character before you make any edits, Christopher Wray, said it provides the capacity to maliciously modify or steal information, and it provides the capacity to conduct undetected espionage. Of course, not everyone agrees with that. On the other side, you have people like Fortune magazine and the Chinese company themselves shooting back saying,
don't you think there's a little bit of economic protectionism at play here? I mean, these are foreign companies, and the U.S. has a big smartphone market. I mean, Apple is a company inside the U.S.
And so you're saying it's just trade protectionism?
I'm saying it could be. I'm just saying there might be an element of that in here.
He put it a lot nicer than Huawei's spokesperson did, who essentially said that U.S. companies couldn't compete with their 5G, which is why we banned their tech. But think of all the good people over at T-Mobile, the best company for dropping the calls you don't want to take. Just say you have T-Mobile and then hang up. They'll understand. Huawei sees this as a national authority targeting a business corporation. Because, again, this company is, on paper, a private company not owned by the government. Now, there are two things to think about at the core of this issue. First, are Chinese telecom companies spying on us? And second, because our telecom companies certainly are working with the US government to spy on other people, how will countries switching to Chinese internet service providers affect us? So the first question, again, is how private is a Chinese private company? A question many think China gave a resounding answer to in 2017.
Lawmakers are set to discuss the draft law on national intelligence, which aims to increase and guarantee national intelligence and protect national security and interests.
Well, that was a lot of words. To put it simply, in reforming these cybersecurity laws, China officially codified that private companies are required to help the government in regard to espionage and offensive intelligence operations. Which really hurts the whole we're a private company and not a part of the Chinese government argument. Conveniently enough, all of the company's data by law also has to be stored in China. So even if the company refuses to cooperate, you can just walk over and take it. At the same time, I don't want to throw stones from my gorgeous glass house, because some listeners are probably reminded of the Snowden leaks right now. That revealed that the National Security Agency was buying customer data from American telecoms operating domestically and abroad. But that's us, and not China, and we're better because we buy your data while they take it. See, respecting private companies. We're capitalists in our communist tendencies. So what sort of thing could happen? Well, this debate is currently happening in the background of Britain.
Raising the fear that China's government will gain ground-level access to, even control of, the UK's critical data infrastructure, prompting a former security minister to urge the government to act.
Well, that sounds pretty risky. Canadian researchers who are currently weighing the risks of all of this as well said that this could give the Chinese government access to how, when, and where everybody uses their devices, as well as manipulating data and harvesting intellectual property. Then again, it's really fast internet. Plus, in another not at all suspicious move.
What does that say about when 5G is rolled out around the world, how this will sort of divide countries in terms of what they choose to adopt?
A lot of people are going to buy from the Chinese and particularly from Huawei because it's subsidized. It's heavily subsidized and you get maybe a 20% discount. They'll go out of their way to give you good terms.
They're getting massive subsidies from the government to lower their prices because they're a totally independent company. Instead of raising prices in a market you're dominating, you're trying to go as cheap as possible. Real Facebook move. And we all know how that data issue was resolved. Again, in Huawei's defense, people are saying that there is no evidence that since the new cybersecurity laws of 2017 compelling private companies to actively perform intelligence operations for the government past they've been used. But come on, that's like saying, well, he hasn't shot the hostage yet, I think we can really trust this guy. Americans, though, don't worry about this, because the US is currently sticking with our more expensive, slower internet that only our government and a myriad of private companies can use to track you. Now to the other issue, the issue of our government stealing everyone's information versus China doing that exact same thing. Because some think we might be losing some of our espionage capabilities abroad as we see debates like...
Kenya has delved into the ongoing debate about the safety of the gadgets of Chinese telecommunications giant Huawei, asking the African Telecommunications Union, ATU, to announce the continent's position on the matter. ICT Cabinet Secretary Joe Musheru has asked the ITU to make public the continent's stand on the matter, which has already seen two top Huawei officials detained by Canada over fears that the firm's wireless 5G technology could be used for espionage by China.
Countries across the world are debating whether to transition towards relying on Chinese telecoms, because they want that sweet, sweet 5G. Ah, man, and just as American companies were acquiring towers to provide 3G and 4G coverage to Kenya. Because of its price and quality, Huawei is currently kicking American technology's butt, and subsequently kicking American intelligence operations out of Latin America, Africa, and the Middle East. I mean, they sell more phones than Apple and are leading in 5G tech. Someone has to be buying this stuff. The question for most of the non-traditionally Western world is less, oh no, China's spying on us, and more, well, someone's gonna be watching us either way, might as well go with the cheapest and best option. Although, if Canada and Great Britain are still considering this, it's gotta be a pretty good deal. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hey YouTube viewers, I hope you liked this episode. If you did, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the right of my head, or do it the old-fashioned way by clicking the subscribe button below. Share so that everybody can learn, and give us a like if you like what you saw. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching.